In this video, we are going to review how to obtain cardiac output measurements on a patient with a pulmonary artery catheter. So what is cardiac output? It is the measurement of the amount of blood the heart pumps in 1 minute. It is measured in liters per minute and calculated by multiplying the heart rate times the stroke volume. Normal cardiac output is 4 to 8 liters per minute, and it reflects overall cardiac function. You will need a 500 milliliter bag of D5, a cardiac output set, and a cardiac output cable. Here at Salem Hospital, the cardiac output cable is the brown cable that has a temperature sensor and a temperature probe at the end. It plugs into the brown port on the bedside monitor. And of course, you will need a patient with a pulmonary artery catheter in place. Next, I will demonstrate how to connect the cardiac output set to your patient. You will first connect the temperature sensor of the cardiac output cable to the thermistor on the pulmonary artery catheter. Next, you will connect the temperature probe of the cardiac output cable to the injector of the cardiac output set. It only fits one way. Spike the bag of D5 with the tubing of the cardiac output set and prime the injector by pulling the plunger, ensuring no air gets into the injector. Connect it to the proximal port of the pulmonary artery catheter. Turn the three-way stopcock open to the patient and off to any infusions. If you have any medications running through the proximal port of the PA catheter, consider switching them to a different port. Now you are ready to inject. As the room temperature D5 mixed with blood passes through the right atrium, right ventricle, and then into the pulmonary artery, the temperature changes. The temperature probe at the end of the PA catheter inside of your patient measures this temperature change. The change in temperature is then plotted on a time temperature curve on the bedside monitor. The rate of blood flow is inversely proportionate to the change in the temperature over time, and this decrease in temperature is inversely proportionate to cardiac output. In the next video, you will see how cardiac output measurement is calculated on a bedside monitor. On the bedside monitor, in the box that displays the patient's core temperature, click the CO button. Inject when ready will display on the screen with a grid for cardiac output calculation. When you inject, you will see the time temperature curve. Once the cardiac output is calculated, you will see the values displayed within the grid along other hemodynamic values. You should perform at least 3 trials, and the values should be within a few tenths of a point of each other. If you get an erroneous value, you may delete that trial by selecting the trial you want to delete and selecting the Delete CO Trials button on the screen. The monitor will average out your trials and display the value. Now you have your averaged cardiac output measurement. For further information on cardiac output measurements, please refer to the Lippincott procedure, Cardiac Output Measurement with Room Temperature Injected. And remember to hit that subscribe button below so you'll stay in the know of new resource videos posted to the Salem Hospital CCPD YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.